Hey, FLB Youth, it's Pastor Cody. I hope you super enjoyed yesterday's devotional done by Kevin Starkey. I'm glad that he was able to do it today. We are on day three of this devotional of Chosen and Appointed. And so what I want to reach out to you guys is I want to challenge you. Today is a day that, you know, many of us can take to heart. It's something that, you know, really challenges us. And I want to dive into the scripture first. And it talks through Isaiah 43. And it says, "But now, O Jacob, listen to the Lord who created you." So what he's saying is for us to listen. Obviously, when the Bible says listen, we need to listen. But it says, who created you? And God created us. And it says this, "O Israel," or you can, you know, put in your name, "Pastor Cody, the one who formed you says, do not be afraid, for I have ransomed." Ransom just basically means there was a payment demanded or there was a payment paid for the release of a prisoner. And in that regard, it was us. It was the release of our life from sin, from hell, from grave, from sickness. And it says that, "Do not be afraid, for I have ransomed you. I have called you by name. You are mine." And so, in regard to this is, today's whole title is God Don't Make Junk, or God Doesn't Make Junk. God, like we talked about, chose you. He has called you to be sent to do something for him. And he's chosen me. And so think of that at the end of it. It says, "I have called you by name." He called you by name. And then he says this is, "You are his." Says, "You are mine, you are the Lord's." And so, I don't know about you, but how many of you have ever thought about the reason why you were born? The reason why you're here on earth, the purpose you have? You know, growing up, I was in a divorced family. You know, you've heard my story, most of you. I've been attacked by a dog when I was little, had a couple surgeries because of that, and have tons of stitches and all of these things in my life that has happened that I've wondered, like, God, why did you let that happen? Why am I the way I am? Why am I here? Why am I on earth? And the fact is this, that God created me for a purpose. He created me unique and different from every other person. And my story is different than every other person. The same way it is for you. God created you unique. He called you by name. And you are his. And so I hope that you can take a moment to just wrap your head around that. That the God who created the heavens and the earth created you unique. Not only did he create you unique from everyone else, but he ransomed you. He paid the price for you and me alike. But then it comes to this. It says, he has called you by name and you are his. So something that we can learn through today's devotional is this, is the God of Jacob, the God of Israel, the God of Isaac, the God who created everyone and everything and every being, made you in his image. He made you perfect. So wrap your head around that. Is say to yourself this statement, God, you don't make junk. You made me perfect in your sight. Not only that, but I want you to say another thing. It says, just say this to yourself, Lord, today I'm going to let you love me. And prepare yourself to be amazed. Why? Is because when you think that God made a mistake, you negate his love for you. Why? Because God made you in his image, unique than anyone else, and your unique qualities are the qualities that sometimes you try and push yourself away from, or you try and say that they're mistakes. But in reality, those perfect qualities that God gave you that are different than everyone else set you apart for the purpose that God has you here on earth. And what is that? To be sent, like we talked about yesterday. So I want to pray, but I hope that you can just keep that in mind, that you are uniquely made, perfect in his image, and in his sight, he called you by name, and you are his. So let's pray. Lord, I thank you so much for today. And Lord, I just thank you for these students who are listening in, God, that there is a unique purpose for them to be here on earth. And Lord, I just pray that they would remind themselves that that you don't make junk, that they are perfect, and everything about them, their flaws, their unique qualities, their different qualities from everyone else, are what set them apart, God. Remind them of that. Remind them to allow you to love them, God, in their flaws and in their strengths. I pray that in Jesus' name. Amen.